question today is, how can we study the Bible and actually have it make sense?
We know that God is all-knowing and has inspired the biblical writers to communicate his plan to us through the Bible. Having our foundation built on the scriptures means that we must accept that the Bible is correct and harmonious. It is our duty as followers of Christ to study the Bible and try to come to an accurate understanding of all of the scriptures. In fact, one reason that Jesus spoke in parables was so that only those who really wanted to know him were those who were willing to study and learn and would therefore be able to understand him.
How can the same book have so many interpretations and still have validity today? It's been said by many people that you can make the Bible say whatever it is you want it to say, but is that true?
Because we know that God has a plan, and that plan is harmonious and perfect, it makes sense that he would be able to communicate that plan to us. What you might ask yourself is, how can we know how to put all the pieces of the plan together in the right places and order?
Topic study is an important way to understand the truths that are held in the Bible.
There are many scriptures that interlock together or cover similar situations or ideas. For example, the Gospels. They cover some of the same or similar accounts of Jesus' life. You can read the whole Bible and try to learn about a specific topic or lesson as you go along. However, by studying one topic at a time and comparing different scriptures related to that topic, it's much easier to understand. By being more specific, you can bring together the necessary related scriptures and accounts to draw a clearer picture of what's really going on. In this age of information, studying topically has become much easier. One advantage of the many resources available for study is the ability to go back to the original Greek and Hebrew words to fully understand their meanings. Many times, words in our English translations of the Bible don't allow us to truly understand the nuances and meanings of the words in their original languages. God has created a perfect and harmonious plan, which means that when you end up with scriptures that seem to contradict each other, it's important to use the following studying steps to understand their true meaning and intent.
A good example of how to best study is through an examination of words.
There are several books that allow us to look at the full definitions of each word in Hebrew and Greek, and those include Strong's Exhaustive Concordance and Young's Analytical Concordance. These study aids have allowed us to more completely understand God's plan. For example, a study of the word hell in the Old Testament is a translation of the Hebrew word Sheol, which has been assigned the Strong's number 7585. Looking at the definition of the word, we see that the word means grave, or pit, and in comparing the ways that it's been translated in the King James Version of the Bible, there are times when the same word is translated to mean two very different things depending on the context. Compare the following two verses, which use the exact same word. Genesis 37:35 says, "All his sons and daughters came to comfort him, but he refused to be comforted. No, he said, I will continue to mourn until I join my son in the grave." That word grave is the same word as found in Amos 9:2. However, in the King James translation, it is translated the word as hell. "Though they dig into hell, thence shall mine hand take them. Though they climb up to heaven, thence will I bring them down." These differences in how the same word is translated leads us to a greater need to study exactly what hell is. Without looking more deeply into how this one word is translated, it can lead us to assume that hell is a place of torment and torture. It's essential to any student of the Bible to look deeply into aspects such as this and not accept what we have heard from people that we assume are more well-studied than we are. If you take the time to study this topic to its logical conclusion, it will be found that the word oblivion is the best synonym for the Hebrew word Sheol, and its Greek, the New Testament counterpart, is Hades. So we learn from this very quick study of the original words that hell is not eternal torment. It is oblivion. It is not only for the wicked, it is also for the good. It is not permanent, it is a temporary oblivion, or non-existence, or death state.
Check out our video, What's the Truth About Hell, for more information on this specific topic.
So each of us can identify a topic that we would like to study and begin.